Hey YouTube, Burbilly here. Today I want to talk to you about these cooler AC units that people are making. Are they worth it, and should you build one? My opinion, it's no and no. I built one and been doing some tests on it here over the last month, and I'm not really seeing great results with it. I want to show you some of the tests I did, just temperature drops, things like that, and talk about some of the other options that are out there maybe if you're interested in building one of these. But this is the one that seems to be most popular out there, where they use like a Walmart fan. It's 12 volt DC, runs to a cigarette lighter plug, and then you put either a 4 or 6 inch pipe coming out. In my case, I put these just his elbows coming out, and I've actually got this one blocked off because I found that it was too much airflow going out. This, having two of these, seems to be the sweet spot. So that's what we're going to run with for our test. I've got 22 pounds of ice in here. I loaded it up. This is a 48 quart cooler. And I've let it sit for about an hour, so we should have some nice cold air in there. It's hot, hot, hot here in Cleveland today. It's probably somewhere in the mid-90s. Relative humidity is through the roof. We're probably, I'm guessing, well above 50%. According to this, we're about 64%. Now, we're in my garage area, which is got the house air conditioning it partway, so there may be some condensation effect or something going on here that may have jacked it up a little bit, but it is humid. Just trust me on that. So I'm going to bring the camera in, and we're going to take a look at the temperature gauge on my meter, and that's set. The probe is set right inside this one. There is some cool air coming out of there, so it'll probably be a little bit lower reading than what this is. But what we're after really is just to see those temperature drops. So this meter is showing 65% relative humidity, 87 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, so I have the probe inserted there into the vent. It's showing a temperature around 81 degrees Fahrenheit. So we're going to go ahead and turn it on and see what it does. These probes are sensitive, so it's already dropping. There's about a 15 degree drop, and now it's holding.
There's not a ton of air coming out of this thing.
All right, so there's not a lot of air coming out of it. These fans just aren't that powerful. And one of the things that you're doing now is you're taking all this hot air, you're shoving it in there, and it's just gonna melt that ice super fast. My take on it. I've tried freezing bottles of water, mixing it with ice, using ice packs, freezing up ice blocks inside of bags, like gallon bags, and putting ice blocks in there. I'm basically getting the same results. It's just not powerful enough to really cool anything. I don't know that this would even take a room down, especially on a hot day. I have to take issue with the claim that this thing would cool a room. Maybe if you've already got your air conditioning running, it'll knock the room temperature down a little bit. But fighting against Mother Nature and some intense heat, I wouldn't want to be locked in a room with this, counting on this as the thing to keep me cold. Let's go ahead and we're going to take this fan off, and we'll put on the Ryobi battery fan, and we'll see if we can maybe get a better temperature drop.
So I'm definitely getting better airflow, and it knocked us down another degree or so. We'll let it run for a second, and I'll see if it makes a change. Keeping in mind that the indoor thermometer is telling us that it's 86 degrees Fahrenheit. Gauge here is telling us that it's 65 degrees. That's a 20 degree drop. The problem is the airflow. You're just not getting enough, in my opinion, to cool down a room. You're not moving enough CFM or cubic feet per minute. You're just not moving enough of that to have an impact on a room.
So my take on this, it's a novel concept. It's neat. It makes you go, wow, that's pretty awesome. You know, that's a great idea. Who thought of that? But the reality of it is when you put it into practical use, does it really work? And I would say, from my experience, no. This is not something that actually works. Now, I have seen other people out there that have put more powerful fans on them. There's one guy, I saw his video, I'd like to try this out. He actually got a Marine 12 volt motor, mounted it on the side, and ran piping through his bottom of his cooler, and then comes out the side over here with just one vent, and it's a smaller vent. And he's claiming that he can cool his car down with it. So that may be the next video for me, is to try that out. I'm giving it serious consideration, but as far as this one, this is the big one that I've seen out there that you see a lot of these where people do them, and they're, oh, this is the greatest air conditioning concept. No. Hey, as always, I hope you enjoyed watching this. I hope you found it helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.